Several of you have asked if I had a single slide that linked all the financial statements together. And so I do, and I'll post that, but I also wanted to post a short video that explains it. So, as you remember, in week one and week two, we introduced the balance sheet equation as a way to capture and record transactions that ultimately leads to the financial statement. So if you think about it, this balance sheet equation is really set up to capture all the transactions. We just looked at it as one transaction at a time, but you can think of there being a giant balance sheet, a giant Excel spreadsheet that captures all the transactions of the firm throughout an entire period, whether it's a month, 3 months, or a year. So if you thought of this as just a snapshot of a much larger spreadsheet, and it contains all the transactions that the firm has entered into for the year, then it also serves as the template to create the three financial statements. So the beginning balances in all the asset liabilities and stockholders' equity account is essentially the balance sheet at the beginning of the year. And then after having a year's worth of transactions, the ending balances in all those columns simply becomes the balance sheet at the end of the year. And then the columns of data on the left and right become the cash flow statement and the income statement. On the right side, we've been capturing all the revenues and expenses. That becomes the income statement. And as the little arrow shows, it feeds into retained earnings. So in the first year, the retained earnings balance is the same as net income. This would be reduced if the firm paid any dividends, but of course they don't. And the cash column on the balance sheet contains all the information for the statement of cash flows. So you can see this really is the expression of the linkages between all three financial statements.